It was a job for angry men. Men who had been hurt as boys and those who were good at dividing their work into the dark parts of their minds. We would brutalize men, drive spikes into their hands and feet, gamble for their earthly possessions, and watch them die. Then we would go home and have supper with their wives and children. It was early in the morning when we led Jesus and the others to Calvary that day. I knew Jesus. A friend stationed in Galilee told me how he had gone up to him and asked him to heal a servant. Jesus never even touched a servant. He spoke a word and the man was healed. My friend convinced it was a miracle. My friend told me that Jesus was not the typical would-be Messiah. He wasn't raising up an army to drive us out of the country. He taught people how to love their enemies, to pray for those who harassed them, and to turn to the other cheek. I told my friend we could use a few more like him in Judea. There he was, being marched to the skull. As I looked at him naked, the crown of thorns upon his brow, for the first time in a long time, I felt a deep regret for what I was about to command my men to do. Yet this was my job, and he was just a Jew. Pushing back any semblance of compassion from the recesses in my mind, I gave the order to nail him to the tree. I watched him throughout the day, listening as he spoke. He took the abuse hurled at him with dignity and strength. It was as if he, with the crown of thorns, really was the king and we were his rebellious subjects. Yet far from calling our destruction, this king pled from our mercy. Remarkable. I watched as the dark clouds rolled in at noon. An eerie feeling lingered for 3 hours. It was as if the heavens themselves were proclaiming the darkness of the deed we were witnessing. Something felt wrong, dreadfully wrong. Then as a small earthquake shook the ground, some people fled in fear, terrified that this might be a sign from God. At 3 o'clock, Jesus cried out, "I thirst!" One of the religious leaders surprised me by breaking away from his colleagues and giving Jesus a drink. Then Jesus said, "It is finished." What a strange thing to say as he approached death. This was a cry of victory, a man successfully completing a mission. Just before he breathed his last breath, he gathered his strength, pulled himself by the nails and wrists, and said in a loud voice, "Father, into your hands I commit my spirit." And then he bowed his head. It was the most remarkable death I've ever seen, and I've seen many. I stood there looking at this man. I was overwhelmed by a sense of fear. What have we done? I turned my men and said to them, "Surely this man was innocent." He was, as we claimed, the Son of God, and for the first 7 years, I wept.